sitting up in the back. There are a few seats down here in the middle and in the front. I don't want you to feel like you have to stand up for the whole concert. Get friendly with your neighbor. Come on and join in. Please be comfortable and enjoy the concert. Here we go.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Rob Natter. I'm the Director of Choral Music here at Gettysburg College, and I'm very pleased to welcome you to our Fall Family Weekend Concert. Thank you so much for being here. We want to extend a special welcome to family members of the singers in the concert tonight. If you're a family member of the singers in the concert tonight, will you raise your hands high and proud, please? Look at that. That's awesome. Thank you for coming out and supporting everybody. I'll say again to the folks who are standing in the back, there are still some seats down here in the front. Don't be shy about coming in and finding a spot to be comfortable for the whole concert, okay? All right, I'm talking on a mic in part because I have a bit of a cold and I'm losing my voice, so I'm gonna do the best I can to tell you a little bit about the music as we go along. Concert Choir began the program with a piece by Henry Purcell. He wrote it for the birthday of Queen Mary in 1694. So it's music for a birthday party. And we thought it'd be nice to open the concert with a piece that was celebratory for a celebration. But now we're gonna get a little bit more serious. The next piece, I Empower, was written as a response to a protest march about the proliferation of school shootings that have been happening in recent years. It's about the power of peace and determination. This week, of course, we've been hearing about yet another mass shooting incident in Lewistown, Maine, where 18 people were killed, 13 injured. So unfortunately, this next piece is sort of eerily appropriate. So let's dedicate I Empower to all those affected in Maine and by this kind of violence all over the world, hoping that we can inspire the power for change. Here's I Empower.
The rumble of thunder before the rain.
And now, as they say, now for something completely different. Since we're so close to Halloween, we thought it would be good to include some music with a spooky bent. So we'll finish with The Ballad of Sweeney Todd from the musical of that name. Some of you may know it. It really requires switching gears, having just sung a song in the spirit of anti-violence, to sing a song about a madman who kills people in his barbershop for revenge and makes them into meat pies and sells them to the public. But we hope you'll understand it here in the spirit of drama and spooky fun. Here's The Ballad of Sweeney Todd.
Oh,
for those standing in the back. There are still a few chairs here in the front. I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Don't sit in my chair. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are some others back there. So don't be shy about coming and finding a spot to sit, if you will. As Audeamus comes on, I'll tell you a little bit about the music that they're going to sing. Hey folks, can I have your attention, please? Thank you so much, Audeamus is gonna begin with a song called One Voice, which is in a folk song style. Some of you know the Wayland Jennies? Anyone? Canadian folk song group? Well, you're gonna learn their song. It's all about the joy and trust of singing together. Tonight it's gonna be conducted by Emily Femino, who is a senior music ed major, and with Sam Stankovic on guitar there. So you'll hear that in a moment. The next song, Shadow River, is about the power of nature. The idea is that when so much of what happens in life is fleeting, nature is always powerful, always dependable. Listen for the sound of the river in the piano part, Shadow River, right? Finally, we also include a song in Halloween spirit. Hexenlied, Witch's Song, is by the German romantic composer Felix Mendelssohn and paints a dramatic picture in spicy German of witches gathering for a bacchanal with Beelzebub. And also, there's a fire dragon. Not bad. Okay. So we'll begin with One Voice and we'll hand it over to Emily. I need just a moment. All right, here comes the Camerata. Camerata is an 8-singer ensemble that sings vocal chamber music, all kinds of music for small groups, everything from madrigals to vocal jazz, and we'll sing some of both for you tonight. We begin with Fair Phyllis, a madrigal from the 16th century. Madrigals often tell a story. They were like the TikToks of their time. They didn't know I was going to say that. Here, Phyllis has gone missing. Oh no! And her lover, Amyntas, goes all around the hills, up and down, up and down, up and down, to try to find her. And then, well, you'll see what happens in the end. The second song we'll sing tonight is a wonderful classic love song, The Nearness of You, one of the great jazz standards, a ballad by the great Hoagie Carmichael. And then we'll finish with a song inspired by the 1960s group, The Swingle Singers. They got famous by doing a cappella versions of pieces by composers like Bach and Mozart, but using scat syllables and jazz styles. They inspired Darman Meter to write this homage to them, and it's very cool. Okay, so here's the Camerata. I'm gonna do three pieces for you.
She was missing when he found her. Do, 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 do
college, excuse me, college choir began with a song about the power of singing music with your friends and about hope for the future. And I maybe got the shtick, but since it's Will the Circle Will Be Unbroken, we thought it would be effective to sing in a big circle. We turn now to Sure on This Shining Night, which is another song about the awesome power of nature, its power to heal and to bring hope. And then after that, college choir will finish with our quirky piece in the spirit of Halloween, Unicornis Captivatur. This piece has a unicorn, a viper, a lamb, a lion, a pelican, a phoenix, a hydra, that's a water snake, and a crocodile. I've never known a piece with so much animal imagery. The text of this piece comes from a medieval manuscript, and the animals come from the medieval bestiary, which is basically the monks using animals, both real and imaginary, as allegories for Christian symbols. So there are familiar symbols like the lion and the lamb, both returning from the dead as symbols of Christ's resurrection. But there are also less familiar symbols like the hydra enters the crocodile, kills it by eating its entrails, and comes back alive. That's the Halloween part. Also another symbol for the awakening Christ figure, but also a symbol of hope for the defeat of evil and renewal in the world. And because of that, lots of alleluias. Right. But first, here's Sure on the Shining Night.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh, you've been such a great audience. Thank you so much. All right, two more songs. To finish the concert, we've combined the college choir and concert choir for two movements of the major work Credo by Margaret Bonds. I'm always looking for music by underrepresented composers, and Margaret Bonds was an excellent Black American woman composer, all underrepresented factors in the music world. Credo was composed in 1967, and it was performed just a few times back then, and then sat unknown in the library for 30 years before it was revived. 30 years. It's now being championed by conductors and choirs all around the country. The text is by W.E.B. Du Bois, who was a towering figure in Black intellectual culture in the mid-20th century. The classic Credo text is from the Catholic Mass and is a statement of beliefs. Excuse me. Du Bois' text is also a statement of beliefs, but from the standpoint that all people, Black and brown and white, are brothers and sisters and have, quote, the possibility of infinite development, unquote. It's ultimately a hopeful text. The last movement is about having patience that the world will finally turn out as it should be. We began the program tonight talking about events like the shootings in Maine, but of course, there are other troubling events happening in the world right now. We've been hearing in the news about the terrible violence happening in the Middle East, in Israel and Palestine. And of course, the war in Eastern Europe continues. We have members of our musical community, some on this stage, who have connections to those places and people. We've talked some in the choirs about how to acknowledge these events without necessarily taking sides or being political, but still condemning the violence that plagues our world. These last two pieces seem appropriate in that context. Songs with ideas for all people to strive together toward unity, peace, and the possibility of infinite development. So we'll dedicate this music to people all around the world who are entangled in violence, with the hope that peace is coming and that the world will finally turn out as it should. Thank you for coming tonight. We've really enjoyed singing for you. We hope you enjoy these last few pieces, and yay for family weekend. And you all should come to all our concerts. Thanks so much.